Hello, everyone. Before we begin, I'd like to ask that you please mute your devices so that we have great sound quality. It would be greatly appreciated. I am Bernard Dotson, and I'd like to welcome you to the celebration of life of our beloved friend, the sophisticated gentleman, Bruce Eugene Heath. Bruce and I met in the early 90s. And he cast me in a European tour to play the Greg Burge role in Sophisticated Ladies. Bruce became one of my best friends and mentors, and he taught me so much about show business and taught me to bring all of myself to every role that I was playing. I am honored that he became an enormous influence in my life as part of my chosen family. He will always have a very special place in my heart. Today, September 10th would have been Bruce's 68th birthday. As we sit, watch, and listen to this program, let us all reflect on his greatness and how he touched each and every one of us in very special ways. And now to sing Duke Ellington's Love You Madly, the incomparable Ty Stevens.
Sounds like the lyric of a song, but since it's so, I thought you ought to know. I love you madly. Better fish are in the sea. That's not the theory for me, and that's for sure. Just like I said before, I love you madly. If you could see the happy you and me, I dream about so proudly. You know the breath of spring that makes me sing my love song so loudly. Good things come to those who wait, so just relax and wait for fate to let me see the day you say to me, I love you madly. Ba-da-da-da. Play on my recorder. If you could see the happy you and me, so proudly, you know the breath of spring that makes me sing my love song so loudly. Good things come to those who wait, so just relax and wait for fate to let me see the day you say to me, love you madly, I love you madly, I love you madly. Richard Cummings on piano.
Hello, everybody. My name is Phineas Newborn III, and I first met Bruce in 1982 because I was a super fan of Sophisticated Ladies and just literally had the best time of my life when I moved to New York and found him here as well. I have the honor of actually reading Bruce's obituary. Bruce Heath was born on September 10th, 1954, to Gladys and Jay Heath in Jamaica, Queens, New York. Bruce was the middle child between his older brother, Donald, and younger brother, Robert. He was the boy in this neighborhood who danced and started dancing at the tender age of four. His beloved mother enrolled him in Gloria Jackson's dance studio in Jamaica, Queens, taking tap, jazz, ballet, and African dance with the late Laroque Bey. Miss Gloria, she was affectionately known, exposed him to all forms of dance and Broadway shows. Bruce was mesmerized by the costumes, choreographies, songs, and musical numbers, hence theater magic began to flow through his veins. Bruce's love for the art form didn't make for a most comfortable circumstance with his male peers in his neighborhood, who often called him names and threatened him. However, Bruce was a force to be reckoned with, and pursuing dance was his passion, and he was not letting anything or anyone stop him from chasing his dream. In 1968, Bruce auditioned for the High School of Performing Arts, and he got accepted. 4 years at Performing Arts perfected his technique and tenacity for dance, reinforcing his creative foundation that would be the catalyst for his spectacular career. After graduation, Bruce wanted to move to California to pursue television and film, and that's precisely what he did. Before Bruce's 18th birthday, he boarded a plane to Los Angeles with only $60 in his pocket and had plans to study dance at Cal Arts School of Dance, which he got accepted on a scholarship. Once he arrived, he had the privilege to meet Donald McHale, the artistic director of Dance of Cal Arts. As a choreographer, McHale hired Bruce for the Bill Cosby Show in the Inner City Repertory Dance Company. In 1973, he was cast in the ensemble of Lester Wilson's $600 and a Mule, which led to the movie Funny Lady, and several television special appearances, including the Academy Awards, the American Music Awards, the Soul Train Music Awards, and countless other television appearances. With numerous job prospects and a demanding schedule, Bruce gave up his scholarship to CalArts to pursue stage and screen work full time. Bruce was often the only token Black guy in white film and television, and he felt responsible for showing the world that he could dance just as fabulous as the rest of the cast, which he did so fiercely. Bruce's magnetic smile, spirit, and presence would light up a room and stage and any set he creates his presence in. Bruce remained close with McHale, and he gave Bruce his first experience on the Great Wide Way in the show that he choreographed entitled Dr. Jazz. Bruce utilized his tap skills that he learned as a child at Gloria Jackson's dance studio to choreograph a tap solo in the show. McHale, seeing his tap ability, brought him in to be the associate choreographer of the critically successful Broadway show, Sophisticated Ladies. In 1977, Bruce connected with Louis Johnson and was hired to be part of the skeleton crew for the Wiz movie, which was the opportunity to be used by Johnson to create all the choreography for the film and to facilitate the cattle call of dancers that would audition for the film. After years of performing as a dancer, Bruce organically progressed his choreographic and directorial roles. In the early 80s, Bruce co-founded the Rainbow Connection along with Chip Fields, who also attended the High School of Performing Arts. This joint incentive was an acting school for kids in Los Angeles area, which also offered dance, which Bruce facilitated. He also choreographed a musical entitled In Command of the Children that Chip Fields wrote for the Inner City Cultural Center. Bruce's choreography could also be seen on such artists as the OJs, the Gap Band, and multi-award winning Rita Moreno. In 1984, he created the Tap Dance Show with the four Step Brothers and Peg Leg Bates in conjunction with the Los Angeles Olympics that year. Next up for Bruce was his position as artistic director for the Broadway show, The High Roller Social and Pleasure Club. During the late 80s and early 90s, Bruce noticed dramatic shifts in the stage and screen world, as well as how dance was turning to street and hip hop to attract new audiences. Bruce was old school and trained in the more standard jazz-based technical traditions. And his response to the new trend in the industry was, "I'm not about to start spinning on my head for a gig." Bruce eventually moved back to New York and went to visit Miss Gloria and help take over the studio after she passed. That was his way of giving back with all that he had learned at that little studio on Merrick Boulevard in Queens. Being back home gave Bruce the opportunity to take care of his aunts, who also supported him. They were his biggest fans, and he made sure that they were taken care of until their last breath. In May of 2016, he joined his colleagues from the original production of Sophisticated Ladies on a panel organized by Duke Ellington Center of the Arts. This platform was to share the delightful experiences and memories of working with the most phenomenal cast of Sophisticated Ladies on Broadway and the Los Angeles and Las Vegas companies. A Renaissance man is what best describes Bruce Heath. And we can look back on his life and career with love, fondness, reverence, and a celebration for the legacy he left behind and the cherished memories that we all have for him. To know Bruce was to love him, and to work with him was always filled with excellence, fun, and laughter. Although Bruce is gone from this side of heaven, he is survived by his daughter Siobhan Heath, brother Donald Heath, goddaughter Adia Joelle, and many friends and colleagues who hold him forever in their hearts. Rest in peace, Bruce, and dance with the angels. You are loved and missed deeply.
Hi, everyone. My name is Kathleen Turner, and I represent three families of Bruces: the Gloria Jackson Dance Studio from Jamaica, Queens, the 1972 senior class of performing arts, specifically the modern dance department, and the dancers who were in the Fred Benjamin Dance Company from 1971 to 1972. Bruce was like a brother for so many of us. My earliest memory was when members of the Gloria Jackson Dance Studio were invited to dance at the 1964 World's Fair at the New York State Pavilion. My class did the can-can, and Bruce played the French officer, the police officer. He always lit the stage, dance studio, and crowd with his smile and enthusiasm. Bruce grew as a choreographer at Gloria Jackson's, and over the years, he choreographed many of our dances. They were always the bomb. Bruce's talent continued to develop during our years at PA, and there were many artistic moments that allowed him to grow. Bruce collaborated with drama student Elmore James to create a PA Christmas show, and Gatsy Wall Jones, Keith Simmons, and I were the African dolls. That was so much fun. Bruce was such an encourager, and he was the instrument of my growth as a dancer and performing arts and beyond. My last memory was being a member of the Fred Benjamin Dance Company when Fred called me to come in early on the first day of a performance. I didn't know if I had done something wrong during the final rehearsals, but when I arrived, Bruce was there with Winston DeWitt Hemsley and Fred Benjamin. Fred said he didn't see enough of me on the stage and wanted to give me one of Karen Burke's solos. I didn't know what to say. I looked at Bruce and Bruce smiled, that infectious smile of his that said, "You're good. Listen and do the movement the way you do it." The next moment, Karen Burke came on stage, smiled at me, and taught me the solo. Love you, Bruce. And I know you're in glory, encouraging the angels to do what they need to do.
Glenn, are you there? You're next. You have to unmute.
There we go. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes.
Great. So my name is Glenn Ferrugiari. In September of 1968, I became a freshman at the High School of Performing Arts Dance Department, Modern Dance Division. Many things happened that day. I was about to become part of an extraordinary group of young dancers who would spend the next 4 years of our lives together. Bruce was one of a group of boys who would quickly become my friends. Having no real formal dance training, I watched him for years studying him because he had already spent many years at Gloria Jackson's Dance School in Queens. One of the things I learned watching him and studying him, emulating him, the days we spent dancing in school and out of school. I remember how I followed him to classes by the likes of Fred Benjamin and Michael Peters. My God, how quickly those 4 years flew by. After high school, Bruce moved to Los Angeles, but the PA bond was so strong, it never ended. What a joy it was to see his work on television and in films like The Wiz and on Broadway in Sophisticated Ladies. It wasn't until Bruce moved back to New York that we reestablished our friendship, speaking periodically and having an occasional dinner. Bruce was even at my audition for Sophisticated Ladies when I auditioned for Leroy to be Leroy Reams' understudy. Speaking with him was always so easy. He had this tremendous talent of making you feel loved and at ease. The last time we spoke, it was to inform him of the passing of our dear friend, Ralph. I remember how I felt listening to him struggle to remember the things that I could clearly see. Well, my friend Bruce, your body is healed and whole once again, and you're dancing with angels. One day we will be dancing together again and we will recreate respect because I still remember the choreography. Friendships like that never die. Love you, Bruce. We'll always love you.
May God have rest your soul. Thank you.
Great. Hi, guys. My name is Daryl Richardson, and I have known Bruce since I was a child at Gloria Jackson Dance Studio in Jamaica, Queens. Bruce was one of my first dance teachers. He played a very significant part in my life as a child. In the fall of 1971, when I was 12 years old, Bruce was my intermediate jazz teacher, and Miss Gloria asked him to teach me a dance to audition for the High School of Performing Arts. Every Monday night after class, Bruce would work with me, and also on Saturdays. He would tell me to kick my face, get that leg up, girl, split, roll up, kick your face again, and chenille across the floor. Little did I know that he was whipping me into shape. He was no joke. I auditioned for PA and got accepted. That was a life-changing moment for me and was the beginning of a vision of a career in dance. Bruce had graduated from PA and moved to California. And Miss Gloria was in a
role. Daryl, turn. Okay, go ahead.
Go ahead. Once I graduated from performing arts, I got to audition for the Wiz movie, and Bruce was on the skeleton crew and would be instrumental in helping Lewis Johnson during that cattle call. That was my first audition for a film. I got the gig and worked in the Emerald City scenes. Being on the set with my former dance teacher was so surreal for me at that time. Years later, Bruce was assisting Donnie McHale and was instrumental in hiring me for Evolution of the Blues that ran in Chicago for 6 months. The next career opportunity that Bruce played in my life was hiring me for the Las Vegas company of Sophisticated Ladies. That is where I have met all of these wonderful people on this Zoom, and that experience was amazing. My most recent memories of Bruce are right back here in New York. Prior to COVID, I would reach out to Bruce and several of our PA alum dancers to go see Broadway shows, and often dinner afterwards. We would have the best time, we would reminisce, and Bruce always kept us laughing. Bruce impacted my journey, and I cherish these memories, for they are the very catalyst that made me the dancer and the woman that I have become. Bruce will forever be in my heart. Dance on in the heavens before the throne of God and the angels. You will be missed. Rest in peace.
Hi, I'm Dee Dee Bridgewater, here to honor Bruce Heath. Well, you know, we were in the Wiz together, and then we were in Sophisticated Ladies together, and then I did a show of Sophisticated Ladies that Bruce directed in Venice, Italy, at the opera, the Venice Opera. So, here we go. Me, all by myself. For Bruce. What good is melody? What good is music if it ain't possessing something sweet? It ain't the melody, it ain't the music. There's something else that makes the tune complete. Well, it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do what, 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 do what. It don't mean a thing. All you got to do is sing. Do what, 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 do what. It makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. Oh, just give that rhythm everything you got. Well, yeah, it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. I do what, do what, do what, do what, do what, do what, do do day. I you never, you never, you score the beat of your double point day. I hear the dead, you're the dead, you're the dead. Scorn, you're the bug, you do. Scorn, be, don't play. Bump up the hell, but let day. You're the dead, you're the head of school, you do, ding, ding, ding. Oh, it makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. Just give that rhythm everything, every little thing you have got. You don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do up, 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 do up. Do up, do up, do up, do up. Scoo you doo doo you doo. Ooh. Do up, 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 do up. Yeah. We love you, Bruce. We love you so much. We miss you. Thank you for being in all of our lives.
Thank you so much, Dee Dee. That was awesome, beautiful. And thank you all for joining this celebration today. I'd like to share just a little slice of my experience with Bruce. Back in 1971, after graduating from the High School of Performing Arts and working on the road company of Golden Boy, Michelle Simmons and I made a firm determination to move to Los Angeles with the encouragement and support of Jerry Grimes. Once we arrived, Jerry took care of us. He took great care of us like we were his sisters, and he helped us really establish our dance careers in Hollywood. 2 years later, two young men, dancers from New York out of PA, made the firm determination to move to Hollywood to continue their education and begin their dance career. It was Gary Chapman and Bruce Heath. Michelle, Jerry Grimes, and myself were so excited because our New York family was expanding. I had only met Gary once and never met Bruce, but when they arrived, I just fell in love with them. They were so bright, so eager, and so ready to twirl. Remembering the support and care that Jerry Grimes gave to Michelle and myself, we quickly adopted them and was more than happy to show them off and help them navigate the Hollywood dance scene. I was lovingly giving the name Mother. Now, don't get me wrong, I was only their dance mother. Beyond that, we were partners in crime and we always had a ball together. In other words, we played hard and we worked even harder. Michelle, Gary, Bruce, and myself worked on the Bill Cosby Show and we were part of the Inner City Dance Company with Donnie McHale. Then we all worked together again in the musical $600 and a Mule and the movie Funny Lady with Lester Wilson. After that, these eager, charismatic, gifted, brilliant young men began working with all of the choreographers in Los Angeles, and the rest is history. We lost so many of our dance family. So I so appreciate Bruce having stayed as long as he did. Bruce and I remain close through the years and we shared a godchild together. Once he moved to New York, I never missed meeting up with him and visiting him. And we would just reminisce about the early years and laugh so hard about some of the crazy things that we did. I will miss Bruce. But I will celebrate you, Bruce, twice a year, once on your birthday and once on March 14th, my birthday. This was the day you released yourself to be with your dance family in heaven. Thank you so much for shining so bright and leaving your light in all of us.
Hi, my name is Rinda Pettis. And I am going to give some information regarding my time with him as my teacher at Cal State Long Beach. Bruce Heath, what can I say? A true character and a man after my own heart. I met Bruce at Cal State University Long Beach back in the 80s, and we instantly hit it off. Once we found out our birthdays were on the same day and the same year, it all made sense why we were so close in such a short time. We were considered at that time twin friends from here on out. His jazz class was always fun and high energy. You might come to class tired, but you instantly woke your behind up once he started playing his amazing music and his full-voiced 5, 6, 7, 8. Bruce was so encouraging and enthusiastic when he was teaching that I believe he could make the lame dance across the floor with the confidence of a peacock and the grace of a swan. But when Bruce danced, his whole body would light up and he would make you feel like you were a part of that fire. Bruce taught dance not just as a curriculum in the college catalog, but through his undying love for the art, he taught it as a way of life. Bruce was a teacher in and out of the classroom. We would hang out on the weekends or holidays at his place in Rancho Cucamonga, which I thought wasn't a real place, but he would call that his safe haven. He took to my kids and we all would chill out there. We would and could talk about any and everything. Bruce knew that I was a late bloomer to the dance industry while raising my two children on my own. And he always knew about some of the haterade that I would receive because either from the younger people or those that had a lot more experience than me, which was mostly everyone. And I acted like it didn't bother me. However, when you do that, lie to yourself, it creates a low self-esteem in your spirit. I said something in the nature of not being good enough for something I wanted to do or be, and Bruce stopped me in my tracks and looked at me with those huge expressive eyes of his and said, "Oh no, honey, I don't know what you're talking about. You have just as much right and ability as anyone else to go for what you want." He told me he loved to watch me dance because, as he would say, "Ooh, yes, honey, you were living." There is a lot more I could say, but for the sake of wrapping this up, what professor, director, choreographer, dancer, and twin friend Bruce Heath taught me was this: go for what you want. Believe in yourself, even if others don't, because what you bring to the table is unique in itself because it is you. And what I am is the best at what I do. The beauty in that is everyone can be the best at what they do by being authentically who they are. The only goal and competition there should be in this life is to always try to be a better you. The other positions are already taken. So hence, when I dance, I'm living in the moment of the movement that moves me. Because of teachers like Bruce is why I still teach today, hopefully passing on the torch that was passed to me. And even today, when I dance with this very seasoned body of mine, I can still hear him in his full voice saying, "Honey, you were living." Thank you.
Hi, I'm Joyce Sylvester, and I met Bruce in 1983 in Los Angeles, California. We instantly clicked, and he hired me to teach drama at the Rainbow Connection. The connection were the founders, Chip Fields and Bruce, connecting drama and dance for the community. Now, beyond the man, the dancer, the choreographer, teacher, and director, Bruce was a genuine caregiver. I met his mom, who had polio, and he was always there for her. I met his two brothers, Donald and Robert, and he was always there for them during their trials. I met his aunt, Ruth, who made all the beautiful costumes for his recitals at the Rainbow Connection. And I met his aunt, Louise, who treated him like a son and was his biggest fan. And he even came back to New York City to help his first dance teacher, Gloria Jackson. Bruce made sure they were all taken care of in their last days. And that was the other side of the greatness of the man. So I want to speak and spell out his name. Bruce, B is for our brother, Broadway baby, who balanced between being the baby daddy of his beloved daughter Siobhan, the god daddy for Adia, and the business of show. Bravo, baby, for the balancing act. R is for releves of respect, a revolutionary, the Renaissance man, the rhythmic, reliable, and resilient man. U is for the man understanding folk, but unafraid to speak his mind. upfront, unselfish, uplifting, the ultimate, the unique, the universal Black man. C is for caregiving with a heart of gold, a champion, pioneer for the people, a little crazy sometimes, but you could confide in him, a man not afraid to cry while creating on the fly the colorful choreography. E is for his energy, how he earned a living entertaining while encouraging others, empathetic, enthusiastic, and an electric spirit, always striving for excellence. Now, Heath goes H, a hard worker, helpful, hopeful, humble, and a great sense of humor that illuminated that grand piano smile. E is for his expressive eyes that made sure every single step was correct and in time. A is for his arms and his ambition, and an abundance of work that leaves an amazing legacy, opening doors for generations to come. T is for the master teacher. From tendus to tap, he taught the technique tastefully and will always be thankful for the tireless harvest he sowed. H is for happy birthday, baby, and hallelujah to your name, Bruce Heath. Until we meet again, we know your kicks are higher in glory, but don't try to upstage the angels in the heavenly realm. I love you so much. Rest in peace.
So we have one more thing, Adia. Donna Mendez came on. Did you want to do your part, Donna? Are you there? You need to unmute. I muted you. There you are. You need to unmute though.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Hi, everybody. I'm having a lot of issues today. Just one of those days. My name is Donna Mendez. I'm coming from a different route with my tribute. Okay, I've been having a very hard time with this, but here we go. Those we love never die. Their physical shell is gone, but that special love lives on in our hearts forever. In our times of sorrow, we search for comfort, but there really are no right words. Sometimes we just need to be quiet in our thoughts. For me personally, I find comfort in my fond memories of my beloved big brother, Bruce. Today, on what would be his 68th birthday, I will do just that. Cherishing those fond memories is what I did often after learning of his devastating diagnosis. I'm sorry, like I said, I'm having a rough time today. I choose to hold onto that big, beautiful smile of his that not only lit up his entire face, but also lit up any room in which he was present. His laugh was loud and contagious, and his personality was bigger than life, magnetic, which is why it was effortless for me to latch onto him from the time I met him at the ripe old age of 14 in the dance department of the High School of Performing Arts back in 1969. We not only created special bond in high school where he took me under his wing, but we also performed together on numerous occasions. We danced together in the La Rock Bay Dance Company for many years. He was my very first jazz teacher. And as I've shared with many, I know I told Daryl many times that I remember that first jazz piece that he taught me. I've even incorporated bits of the choreography and dances of my own students. It's my way of honoring him, my way of showing him love, even up until today. what a huge impact he has had on me, even as an adult. We remained close until he ventured out west to LA. When he returned to New York, we just picked up where we left off. The last two times we were together was when I took him to see West Side Story after a great dinner with some wonderful friends. Preceding that, I'm so sorry. We were together for an entire weekend for Dance Africa, where he and Baba Chuck Davis hugged for the last time. They are both now gone. I'm so happy I captured that moment on film. I can go on, but time will not permit me to do so. My biggest regret today, and this is why I'm feeling so bad, is that I did not pick up on the early signs. Maybe I didn't want to. Maybe I was in denial, disbelief. Our conversations became a little more difficult as his disease progressed. We would both laugh about his forgetfulness, as well as mine, blaming it on old age. I had no idea how bad his condition was until he disappeared on me. My numerous calls would go unanswered and unreturned, which was not the norm for Bruce. I immediately knew something was wrong. That's when I blew up my social media, reaching out to everybody and anybody who could help me locate him. I finally got the bittersweet news of where he was, but broken from the details. In closing, today we celebrate my beautiful, mega talented brother, his remarkable accomplishments. I love him so much. He truly left his mark. I'm so proud of him even today and grateful for the 50 plus healthy years we were able to love on each other. Continue to soar with those who were waiting on your arrival, Bruce, especially Gary Chapman. I could just see y'all cutting up right now. I love you. I will always love you.
Hi, I'm Terry Klausner. Thank you, Donna. Feel you, feel everybody. I had the great pleasure of being in the original cast of Sophisticated Ladies and meeting Bruce there and working with him there. And we had a chance to also do a reunion at Birdland in New York. And just a delight, a professional, so much fun always. So the song that I'm going to sing is a song written by Steve Marzullo, a dear friend of mine, played by my accompanist, Bob Bray. And perhaps it has words that Bruce would say to all of us. Love you, Bruce.
Remember me when no more day by day, you tell me of our future. Beautiful, Terry. Beautiful. Hi, everyone. I'm Cheryl Baxter, and I'm Beth Bowles. Beth and I worked with Bruce and Sophisticated Ladies at the Schubert. In 1982 in Los Angeles, we were so fortunate to spend the next two decades with the show. We performed nationally and internationally all over the place, such as LA, Vegas, Long Beach, San Francisco, Texas, Berlin, Florence, Milan, Rome, and Oslo, and other little nooks and crannies in between. I learned so much from Bruce over those years, especially how to set a show fast and furious. And some of you were in those European tours. You know, we only had 5 or 6 days to learn everything. So Bruce would be in one room, I'd be in the other room, and we would just throw choreography at everybody. I remember always on the flight over too, we were tap dancing in the back of the airplane and running numbers on our layover in Paris. Bruce was always laughing, as we all said, and smiling through everything, right? For those of you that don't know the show, there's one number where 4 people are the taxi cab. Now, when you go to a rake stage over in Europe, that taxi cab all over the stage, just all over. So Bruce handled everything though with his great sense of humor. And we worked hard during the day, but what do we do at night then?
Well, we played hard, and that is a running theme here. We went out after the show every night to a fancy European restaurant with Bruce and Alan Weeks, who was playing the Gregory Hines role at the time. We ate and drank like kids, which we weren't. And Cheryl, what was our main course? Grappa. Yes, that's right, grappa. Now, I also had the honor of helping Bruce along with Bobby Walker in setting the poor man's version of Sophisticated Ladies in San Francisco at the Lorraine's Hansberry Theater. The producers wanted to do this show cabaret style, where everyone had one number. As we went along, Bruce found out that these producers were crooks, criminals, shysters, shall we say, and started stealing money and not paying the lighting crew or the cast. People were dropping like flies. Bruce had to have some heated conversations with these hooligans, and it was not pretty. A lot of finger wagging and, oh, you didn't, from Bruce. Eventually, Bruce had to put me on in the taxi cab and in the guy's card game to cover our diminishing cast. And Bruce, with his perfect timing, did know exactly when to take the A train home and hit the road after he was paid. For years, we laughed about that show. All through Europe, we laughed about that show.
Beth and I both met our husbands in Sophisticated Ladies. Yours was the poor version, and mine was in Vegas. So my life is so much better having met Bruce Heath.
And, yeah, mine too. And your child.
My child's name is Ellington. We love you, Bruce.
We love you, Bruce.
Just my Hello, everyone. Hi, I'm Demetria Jennings. I met Bruce in 1999 when I was a senior in college and we moved into the same apartment building. He lived in an apartment directly below me for over 20 years, but Bruce was more than my neighbor, he was my friend. From day one, we instantly connected because of our love for the arts. Bruce was a busybody, so if anything was going on in our apartment building, I knew he would have all the tea. He was always there for me. He was like a dunkle. For those of you who don't know, that's a dad slash uncle. I would go to him to close the clasp of my necklace because I couldn't do it if my nails were too long, as well as he helped me with things around my house that I needed a man's help for because, you know, we're all strong, but he had that strength. We went through September 11th, New York City blackout, and Hurricane Sandy together where we had each other's back. And it was always comforting to know that I always had someone who I could rely on who was only a minute away. Bruce was the best sign in the world, Virgo. And in Virgo fashion, he would give a good read. And he was so extra and I loved it. But anytime I was in his presence, he left me feeling loved, whether it was cheering me on or cheering me up. He was always my biggest cheerleader. He listened when I was up and he listened when I was down. The last time I saw him, he said the same thing he would always say to me. You got my number and you know that you can always call me anytime. I'm so thankful that I was blessed to have him in my life and I will never forget how he was always there for me because he didn't have to, but he did. And for that, I'm forever grateful. I love and miss you, Bruce.
Hello, my name's Adia Joelle, and I'm Bruce's goddaughter. My godfather was very special to me. He supported and encouraged me with everything I wanted to do. That support began as early as children when Siobhan and I would perform a talent review in front of our toughest audience, our parents. When I decided to make a documentary film about my mother, he was there, ready to share his memories of how he knew her and my father as kids.
Okay, hello, thank you for participating in the video. What was your favorite thing about Francis?
I knew Francis since we were very young, but the thing is we went to two different dance studios, two rival dance studios here in New York. They're from Bernice Johnson's, I'm from Gloria Jackson. And they had their performing group and we had our performing group. And in each group, there was a male. So I was the male in my group. Gary was the male in his group. So in the competitions here in New York, we were always competing against each other. But both groups were so fierce that they always would say, oh, there is no winner, but give it to both groups.
He was open to sharing stories and memories with me, like how I was like my parents, allowing me to feel connected to them. We would spend hours on the phone, and he would praise me on being tenacious and going for my dreams. He never stomped on my goals and always lifted me up. He became my father on earth. On the day I got married, he told me my father came to him in a dream to tell him to buy a necklace with my birthstone. That necklace ended up being my something blue, which I didn't have. And one of the best parts of that day was we got to do the father and daughter dance together and we killed it.
Birthday love. Well, Francis, look how old we are now. Gosh, I'm picking up the slack for all you guys that have left me here. But it's fine. It's wonderful. I'm proud and happy to do it, to look after your baby. Y'all claimed her to be mine, so that's where it's at now, and I'm still doing my gig. Mm-hmm. Love you. Miss you. Bye.
He was always there for me in a big way, and I'm missing him greatly. But I am so blessed for our closeness and our love. He was the absolute best.
Funga Alafia. Ashe, Ashe. Hi, my name is Jeffrey Dobbs. And that was one of the first dances if not the first dance that we learned at the Gloria Jackson Dance Studio. I remember Bruce and I standing next to each other behind Mr. Leroy, our tap teacher, as he yelled out, "Hit slide, 1, 2, 3, 4 slide." You know, you Gloria Jackson people know what I'm talking about. But if you know anything about dance studios, you know that there aren't many boys. So because there were so few boys at the studio, Bruce and I became very fast friends. And because there were so few boys, sometimes we would have to dance with kids that were older than we were. I remember Bruce saying to me, "You need to hurry up and grow a couple of inches so you can be as tall as I am." Bruce left after high school. He went to the High School of Performing Arts, as all of you know. He left after high school and moved out to California. Well, I went off to prep school. And I can remember being in my dorm room. I had saved up enough money to buy a small 13-inch black and white TV so I can sit in my dorm room and watch Bruce and Gary on the Bill Cosby Show. And of course, on everything else, on all the award shows. And how proud that made us feel. Because at Gloria Jackson, we were a family. And it wasn't just about the dance, because Miss Gloria was not just about teaching you to dance. She was teaching you how to become a good human being. And Bruce was her number one son. I got a chance to visit Bruce when he was living in Rancho Cucamonga. Yes, somebody mentioned that earlier. That is a real place. And he was so excited that I can come out and visit him in California. We had the best time. But I got really excited when Bruce actually came back to New York and started teaching with all of us at the studio again, sort of reliving our childhood in those same studios, breathing in the same area, and sometimes teaching the same dances that we learned as kids. You know, I've heard people talk about Bruce's dancing and what a great dancer he was, but I also heard people talk about what a good person Bruce was and the excitement and the energy that exuded from Bruce, that every time Bruce was somewhere in a room, there was energy. And I thought about Bruce and I wanted to say something about Bruce that sort of speaks to me and our relationship, because beyond him being a fabulous dancer and a wonderful choreographer and a director, he was my brother. He was my friend. And so when I think about Bruce, I encourage you to live your life out loud, not with a murmur of self-doubt or a whisper of shame or the hushed undertones of guilt and regret. Live your life with the intensity of fearlessness. Live your life with boisterous boldness. Let your life resonate with the tenacity of resolution. Let your unpretentious self-reliance be fully audible. Turn up the volume on your self-esteem. Live your life out loud. Live your life in color. Don't settle for an existence in gray. Life's no fun just sitting in the beige. Didn't your mama tell you that things aren't always black and white? Go on, put on your royal regal purple. You're a king, you're a queen. Folks will be envious and it ain't always easy being green, but that's okay. Open your arms to the orange. Bask in the light of the yellow. Feel the fire of the red. And yes, sometimes you'll have to sit down in the blues, but that's okay too. Live your life in color. Live your life in laughter. When you're walking around with the cloud of doom and gloom hanging over your head, when you feel your feet sinking in the sadness, look for the laughter. Go hunting for the mirth and the merriment. Giggle, chuckle, guffaw. Don't be afraid of the funny. Let your spirit soar on the wings of whimsy. let it take you to a much happier place. Live your life in laughter. Live your life in love. Love thy neighbor. Love makes the world go round. Love story. Love hurts. The greatest love of all. Love, 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 love. So many poems have been written about it. So many songs have been sung about it. So many tales have been told about it. Sometimes it almost seems like a cliche, but really, at the end of the day, is there any greater joy than loving and being loved in return? Spread love. It'll come back to you. Just look around. Look at the people that are on here celebrating Bruce. Bruce Heath, he has touched all of our lives, and we have become a part of his legacy. Live your lives out loud. Live your lives in color. Live your lives in laughter. Live your lives in love. Live your lives like Bruce. Love you, Bruce.
Oh, that was so beautiful, Jeff. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody, for joining us today. This has been quite an amazing celebration of a life well-lived. And I'm just so grateful that we've all been able to join together and to be here for him, knowing that he is now woven into every single one of our spirits, woven into every single fiber of our being. I want to share the last prayer, actually, something that we all learned at Unity of New York. And it's something I'm sure that he would really appreciate me sharing with everybody. And I've changed one word to just allow us to just call his name again. So if you don't mind, just put a hand towards the heavens as I say this prayer. The light of God.
Before you start, can I please say something before you start?
Who's speaking?
Elmore James.
Elmore James?
Yes.
Yes, please go ahead.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt, but I really wanted to say something.
Okay.
Bruce and I met at the High School of Performing Arts. He was 13, I had just turned 14. And we didn't really become friends then, but we knew each other. And as Kathy said earlier, I wrote this musical and he choreographed it with me. And it was a big hit. And then we did the senior show at the end of senior year, and he went off to California. Then he came back and it was in Dr. Jazz on Broadway. And I was so excited to see him in Broadway. And we always had a very, 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 very close relationship. He came to see me when I was living in Sweden on his way to Oslo to do Sophisticated Ladies. And Bruce is my brother. He always was my brother. And as with brothers, you know, you sometimes fight, you sometimes argue. Bruce and I didn't really argue that much. We always had fun. We always collaborated and shared an intimacy that I will forever be grateful for. I just wanted to say that because I don't get an opportunity to trumpet my love for him to the world. So I just wanted to do that today. And I remember Francis and I remember Gary, of course. You know, we were all a very happy band. And thank you for letting me barge in and say something, but I really wanted to say something for Bruce to all of you. Thank you, I love you.
Thank you so much. And just so that you guys know, if anybody else wants to add anything to this to the share, you are more than happy, if you're on social media on Facebook, to actually add words of what your memories might be of Bruce on that and that platform. But I would like to just continue with the prayer. So everybody, please extend a hand to the heavens and just really just know in your heart, the light of God surrounds Bruce. The love of God enfolds Bruce. The power of God protects Bruce. The presence of God watches over Bruce. Wherever Bruce is, we are. And all is well. And I'd like to also just invite you all, especially those of you who might have their cameras turned off, to turn them on if you would, because we would love to actually celebrate our last dance for Bruce together with our last musical selection. Again, thank you so much for joining us today. This has been awesome. I feel Bruce in my heart. I feel Bruce everywhere right now. And thank you so much for being a part of this. Here we go. Bruce loves a good party.
Love you all so much. Bye, Daryl.
Bye, you guys.
Bye, Daryl. Bye, Cindy. Bye, Pat.
Bye, Ray. Love you.
I look great.
Love all my PA families.
Thank you, everybody, for such an incredible
Cuba, is that you?
Thank you so much.
Casey.
Beautiful tribute. Love you all so much.
Thank you.
Unbelievable.
Thank you, Casey. Love you all. Thank you. 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 Thank you.
an exquisite job. Thank you.
Yes, so excellent.
Daryl and
Daryl
and Beth and Cheryl.
You guys.
Daryl, you know, everybody, you know who you are. Our team, we did an incredible job. Everyone did so good.
You're amazing.
There were tears and there were laughter, you know,
yes.
But that's just life. So thank you guys so much for, you know, really putting this together. This was beautiful.
We're a family. Yes.
I love you guys so much.
I hope we can do this again.
I hope
not too soon.
But just don't let it be a memorial. Let's just let it be a celebration.
Yes. Yes. Thank you guys so much.
Okay,
Thank you all. Okay. Okay, bye.
Can't see you. I love you.
Love you too, Kathleen.
Bye.
Take care, Carol. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Indeed, wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Just beautiful.
Carol, thank you so much. Lorraine, I love your lotus blossom. Nam your heart.
Yes. Good to see you, Anastasia. Good to see you. Wow, yes. So many people. I really wish I could have said hello to every single one of you.
Amen.
And Joni, I'm happy to see you. You look amazing.
Joni.
Yes. And who else is on? And somebody else was on that I saw. I hadn't seen it. So Flo, she was on.
There were over 100 people on this.
Yeah,
there were.
Joni was on too.
Diane was on too, actually.
Yeah.
Diane Scott was on and Diane Day was on. So yeah.
Hope
good
was
to
on.
See you all.
Oh, cool.
Candy Brown was on.
Candy Brown, Malaika Bisley from Germany was on.
Hi, Malaika, yeah.
Yes. Yes. And Anastasia, are you from
Berlin? I live in Berlin, but I'm from New York. I'm a PA baby too.
I know.
I came after you guys.
I know.
Yeah, I was there when Daryl was a senior when I was a freshman.
I remember, yes.
Wow. Love it.
But I also remember Jay. Eddie is over here too.
Oh, fantastic. So I'm going to end this. I don't want to, but I am going to end this.
Bye, Donna.
Thank you guys so much.
Love y'all.
See you later.
Bye, darling. Okay, bye.